with murder. On Thursday, we're going with the family of Ezel Ford to the district attorney's office at 210 West Temple Street at 3 o'clock. We want everybody in Los Angeles to hear the story.
Case, I'm sorry. Door.
I'm telling you, keep moving. And don't stop, we're being wretched. My question is, we're talking about mental challenges. Obviously, Roosevelt Norton was challenged as a result of your investigation of his issue. And he was in a mental state. And you got him there, up there in the mountain. Instead of you waiting till he come out like that, you went in and you bombed him out. That's excessive force. And I just wonder if you will use that same attitude in dealing with this investigation of this matter. Anyone can answer that.
Well, you're talking about Christopher Garner. Christopher Garner. Died in a cabin in Big Bear, surrounded by the San Diego County Sheriff, not the Los Angeles District.
Murder! Behind you!
Thank you, sir, for the comment. Next question, please.
If they don't respect people, then I ask you to report them, as it seems you did. And then we will deal with it appropriately. If we need to retrain them, we will. If we need to discipline them, we will. If we need to fire them, we will. But we have to know about it. So if you come forward, then we can deal with this issue.
Thank you. Chief, this question, this comment is for you. Earlier you asked us not to prejudge. Well, your office is prejudged every day. It's called racial profiling. And people are here tonight because we are tired of you guys wantonly killing and murdering black and brown people in our own communities. We should be able to walk down our streets feeling safe. And another thing, we don't want to hear no more excuses. We want this solved.
My name is William Godson. Are there any more family members here? Well, basically, that's the only real reason I came was to speak to the family members. I'll just say this to everybody else real short and simple. These people come to our communities and make life living for us hard. We got to start going to their communities and make life for them hard. Wherever they live at, that's what we got to take this fight. Going in front of the police station ain't working. It ain't working since Rodney King. Going in front of the courthouse, going in front of the city hall ain't work. But it's other people in this country and other countries taking the fight to their front door. Take the fight to where their children are going to school, and I guarantee you this shit will change. All power to the people.
Let our world! At school, we were talking about this, and to know that people my age and my community is getting killed, that's around my age, is terrifying for me and my peer group to even walk out on the street knowing that we could just get killed by holding something in our pockets. It is so terrifying for us, and we talk about this every single day, just to know we could be walking on the streets and we could get killed because they think we have something on us.
And how would it change? How could you envision a place where that wouldn't happen? How would you do that? What would you do? People that are here, what would you ask them in your community? What would you do to change that perception? What would we all do? I'm just asking. She's one of our most vulnerable population, young people in this community. I'm just asking a question.
To come together and to understand everything and to just be united and stop.
Thank you.
One of the things that I like to do, like to offer, by the way, I'm Pearl Pace Center. I'm the director of the Office of Operations. First of all, before I talk to you, I have to say that I've been with the LAPD now for almost 40 years. And like Chief Beck mentioned earlier in his presentation, I've seen the LAPD long before it looked and acted like it did today. To the question of whether or not this organization has changed, I remember early on in my career how I was treated. And one of the reasons that I joined this organization was to help orchestrate change within. Have we gotten there yet? No, we haven't. But the fact is, there was a time when nobody in this room would have been here talking to us. We've not, let me finish. We've come a long way in terms of outreach, in terms of communication, establishing a establishing an opportunity for us to communicate the way we're communicating tonight. To the point of the young lady just a second ago, I've spent the latter part of my career reaching out to young people to provide them an opportunity to grow up in a neighborhood and a community that's free of crime and free of fear. Sir, you had your opportunity to speak. Let me speak to this young lady, please. Young lady, my offer to you is you tell me the time and the place at your school, and I'll be there. That's my pledge.
You know, initially we wanted to see if we could get some more information, get some more facts. And it was clear that those facts, the information wasn't coming. That was important that we have the form. Ideally, yes. When we have a form, we'd like to get some answers, we'd like to get some responses. So it wasn't organized immediately because the information we sought wasn't forthcoming, wasn't available. We decided to move forward with the form, knowing well that there's still going to be lots of questions to answer. But we thought it was important to demonstrate good faith, goodwill, and intent to do the right thing. In terms of budget allocations, I certainly would join you in trying to shift the dollars around in our budget. We certainly need more money for prevention, you know, not apprehension, you know. But you got a role to play too. When we have these budget sessions, you need to be at the table. You need to be organized. You need to be involved, not after that.
We're well, the mayor's budget.
Okay. Well, good. Don't just do it once. Keep doing it. Stay involved. Thank you.
Can you commit? Okay. Can you like actually agree to a meeting? All of your departments, can you sit down and say, let's talk about what 1% from our budget looks like? Because that's how you're going to get peace in these communities, in our streets.
And I'm always going to talk.
And that's the question I guess for everybody. Because at the end of the day, 1% population is from DA's office, it's from LAPD, from the sheriff, everybody in LA.
Sorry. We have very limited time now.
Pavement. Won't somebody just tell them? Won't somebody, oh, won't somebody, oh, 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 oh. Won't you please look after my children? Not a word's from the mouth of the women. Some are getting all the wood to get the fire lit. Some are picking up the pieces in the last days. Won't somebody, oh.